to check pre of one and the next of one.
Yeah.
And then run. So it is previous of one and the one.
Yeah.
And previous next equal to current.
Correct.
And the current previous equal to current, I mean next previous equal to current.
Yes. And?
And
exactly. You have to do that. Okay, that's for get. And if the get value is not present as a key, then you just return minus one. That does that in the problem. Okay? Next there is put. For put, what do you need to do? Put is like the bulky thing. What is the first thing that you do? Yeah, that's the first step. Yeah, if it is there in the hash map, then it's as good as get, but you have a new value. Do everything that you do in get, but you do it with a new value. If it is not there, then you have to check the capacity. If you reach the capacity, then you delete the last guy, add the new guy, put it at the head. If you did not reach the capacity, then just add it to the front.
One down, even
yeah.
In get,
yeah.
How do we know the address of six to make
map.
One? But how do we know that we have to insert it before
good.
Six?
Right? So, yeah, do you guys get her question? So, if there is a new node that's coming in, no,
well,
I mean,
I
just create a new node and,
we
yeah.
Have
yeah, you can do that, but that's true. Let me think this. Yeah, but how will you remove the last guy? Oh yeah, you keep a node two. Yeah, so, right, there's two ways of doing things. Like the clean way of doing things is having two dummies. One at the beginning and one at the end. So, I do that because if, like, let's say I'm just starting off, okay, my hash is of size zero. Then I have to check to see if its size is zero, then I have to do something different. But if I had two dummies, I would do the same thing for every case. Just insert it at the dummy that's at the beginning of the list. Make it the next of the dummy that's at the beginning of the list. And then I'm supposed to delete the node that's right. That's the previous of the end dummy. So there's two dummies, right? One in the beginning and one in the end. So it's always good to like play safe and use dummies. Okay, so yeah, so this problem is very interesting because of the way you come up with this design. Like writing code is just a lot of like typing and then being careful to hit the edge cases. I'll show you the code. So everybody got the solution though, right?
Yeah.
Submitted the code, this was set, and then I tried to run it and it wasn't working. Yeah, so so this is exactly what I spoke about. So this is the get method, and in my class I have, okay, first of all, in my list node, yeah, the key values are both in the list node. And this is a double linked list, so I have a previous and a next, and I have a constructor. And in my LRU cache, I have a capacity, these two are the dummies. And then I have a map. Okay, the list will be stored within, you can access the entire list if you have access to these two, right? Right? So, in the constructor, I just initialize the dummies capacity. And yeah, I link those two dummies because that's my cache. And I just create a new map. And in my get, the first thing I check to see is if the key is not present. If it's not present, then just return minus one. If it is present, then get the node's address from the map. And why did I remove this? Oh, I removed this because put again puts it in the map. Hmm. and then, oh, okay, I think I know why I removed it. Because, I think I did something clever, because put already takes care of removing and putting, yeah, so if I do both these deletes, it's as good as putting it again newly, right? Right, so I just wanted to like make my life easy. Otherwise, I would have had to do the deletion logic in this method and this method. So right now, only put the delete and moving it to the front. Yeah, moving it to the front. So I have a helper to do delete. And once I remove these two, it's as good as putting it away. And yeah, I just return the value that's sitting in that node. Make sense? I mean, there's multiple ways of coding this up. This is just one lazy way of doing it. And then I'm surprised that I did it this way. Again, if the put is already in the key, then I just get it and I delete it. Yeah, I delete it because it needs to go to the front, right? And then I do this. And if it's not present, then I don't do this. I just put it, so I just add it to the front, add it to the map. And if it's going beyond the capacity, I just remove the last guy. So in this problem, the last guy is the next of the first, and the new guy gets inserted in the last. I don't know why I changed the screen. But whenever I want to do like an add node, I add to the last. And like which way you're sorting doesn't matter. Okay? Yeah, that's pretty straightforward. What's another idea? Okay, and then move on to the next one. Okay, once more, this is a research problem. And in 1970s, a guy called Floyd like came up with a solution for this as a part of his PhD dissertation. But you're still expected to solve it in 45 minutes. After like a lot of stress and pressure. But like this is super famous, so yeah, so maybe you can cut them some slack. This is a famous problem, and everybody should know a solution to this. So a linked list cycle is this problem has two parts. One is you have to determine whether there is a cycle, and if there is a cycle, you return this. This node is special, right? This is the only node. This is like the apex of the cycle. So you have to return this node where the cycle begins. If there is no cycle, you just return null. Oh, detecting a graph cycle? Yeah, every linked list is also a graph. Yeah, so in a graph you do that, you mark every node as black, gray, white, like a standard cycle detection algorithm, right? Yeah. I think, I'm not going to use hashing here.
I mean,
the linked list cycle, the graph cycle detection.
Yeah,
so you have a visited, and you have. Yeah, I'm just thinking about, so in graph, a lot of the times, like the algorithms also have the number of vertices as part of their complexity.
Remember?
Yeah, in graphs, you usually have the number of nodes also as part of your complexity, right? Yeah, and each node has only like one neighbor. Yeah. Yeah, I guess you could technically use that, I think.
This is
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, it's
Yeah, so this problem is, yeah, this problem, like, the coding is very easy, but understanding why it works is very tricky. So the code is very simple. So you start two pointers, fast and slow, and fast moves two nodes each time, and slow moves only one node each time. So in my code, I would have slow equals slow dot next, and fast equals fast dot next. Okay, and I start both of them here. Okay? They will eventually meet somewhere. Okay? And wherever they meet, at that point, I create another iterator to the head of the list. Okay, let's say they meet here. Okay? At that point, I'm going to create another iterator to the head of the list, and I'm going to iterate both of these together. And they will meet at the apex. Okay, so the first step is slow and fast. Like, increment them this way, and then keep going until they meet, and they will always meet. Okay?
So each slow step comes back.
They're moving at the same time, but they're not moving by the same speed.
Okay.
So every time slow moves by one step, fast will move two nodes ahead.
Okay.
Yeah. So the claim is that they will eventually meet, and let's say they meet here. Okay, slow and fast meet here. At that time, I create another ITR. And now I only increment one step for each of those. So for my second part, also increment, but they increment at the same speed. So I'll do a sequel to start next, and I equal side on next. And they will both eventually meet at the apex. Okay, does everybody understand the algorithm? Now I'll explain how it works. Okay, so this is gonna get really mathy. So, brace yourself. Can you create another thing?
Wow.
Does everybody remember this?
Or no?
They're
opening and moving. Fast is behind slow, and they move at the speeds that I described, then they will meet three nodes ahead. Because? Here to here, so that's three steps for fast, right? And each
they move at the speeds described, then they would meet end nodes ahead of where SPO is currently. Okay?
Okay, that's the corollary.
So everybody gets this, right? So initially, slow and fast are here. Okay? And then they move, this guy jumps two nodes each time. This guy just goes one node. So eventually, this guy will get here, right? They won't meet here. They can't meet here because fast is just jumping ahead. So I only stop when they meet, right? So the meeting point can only be within the cycle. Accept it? Because fast is like just jumping ahead. So at some point, slow will get here. At that point, where is fast? That is my question. Yeah, so slow covered k steps. So fast is also k steps from here, right? Because it's 2k. But this L could be much smaller than k. So let's say k, this L is 5, and k is some 48. Then where do you say the mu, where do you say the fastest? Modulus, awesome. So if k percentage L node starting from here, right? Let's say k is 48 and L is 5, then it'll be 3 nodes inside because it'll do cycles for 45 times. And then the last 3, it'll just do 1, 2, 3, right? So k percentage L can also be written as k minus lambda L for some lambda.
Oh, because we're counting on that cycle.
Yes. Yep. Okay. So k percentage L is k minus lambda L. And what is the condition on k minus lambda L? Can you say something about the magnitude of k minus lambda L? It would be between 0 and L. So modulo is always less than or equal to 0 and less than L. Okay? So it's k minus lambda here, right? So let's say fast is somewhere here, and this distance is k minus lambda L, right? And what is this distance? Yeah. Right? That is this distance. Okay? Now let's say L minus, let's say this is A. Okay? Now I have that information again, right? I have a fast and I have a slow. Let's say I just take this whole thing and make it into a line. Right? So I have a fast and a slow and the distance between them is A. So where will they meet? They will meet A nodes ahead of this. Right? That means A nodes from here. Okay?
So they meet somewhere here, but that this distance is A. Right? Then what is this distance? L minus A, right? Which is estoy buscando el mandado, estoy buscando el mandado. So this guy gets here, right? And this guy gets mandado. And what is the frequency?
K minus mandado. Which is?
Lambda.
Just lambda. K minus lambda, right? So at some point, this is a resistance lambda L, and this is the apex. And what is the meaning of lambda? It's a multiple of L, and there are L here, right? So this will move 1L and will come here. 2L, 3L, lambda L, that will be here. Right? Is everybody convinced? Yeah. Yeah, it's I know, it's mind bending. Like I read this so many times to make that point to me. But at least it's kind of convincing, right? So L is the length of the circuit, so yeah, it didn't work because the lead code told me that it's like something. Okay, 453, okay, that's way too late. Okay, fine. So we're done. There's another problem, but that's to be expected every time we solve a problem. So really? Okay, let's do it super fast. I love that problem. It's awesome. It's very simple. I'll explain. So there's k-sorted list. Yeah, in G-Fun's class, you did divide and conquer, right?
Yes.
So there's k by 2